God will torment man in eternity for following his energies.
But the following contraries to these are true.
One. Man has no body distinct from his soul, for that called body is a portion of soul discerned by the five senses, the chief inlets of soul in this age.
Two.
Energy is the only life and is from the body, and reason is the bound or outward circumference of energy.
Three.
Energy is eternal delights. Is called Messiah, and the original archangel or possessor of the command of the heavenly host.
is called the devil or Satan, and his children are called sin and death.
But in the book of Job, Milton's Messiah is called Satan, for this history has been adopted by both parties. It indeed appeared to reason, as if Josiah was cast out, but the devil's account is that the Messiah fell and formed a heaven of what he stole from the abyss. This is shown in the Gospel, where he prays to the Father to send the Comforter, or desire, that reason may have ideas to build on, the Jehovah of the Bible being no other than he who dwells in flaming fire.
Know that after Christ's death, he became Jehovah. But in Milton, the Father is Destiny, the Son. A ratio of the five senses and the Holy Ghost.
In fetters when he wrote of angels and God, and at liberty when of devils in hell, is because he was a true poet and of the devil's party without knowing it.
carts and your plough over the bones of the dead. The road of excess leads to the path of wisdom. Prudence is a rich, ugly old maid caught up by incapacity. He who desires but acts not breeds pestilence. The cutworm forgives the plough. Dip him in the river who loves water. A fool sees not the same tree the wise man sees. He whose face gives no light shall never become a star. Eternity is in love with the productions of time. The busy bee has no time for sorrow. The hours of folly are measured by the clock. To wisdom, no clock can measure.
Excess of sorrow.
system was formed, which some took advantage of and enslaved the vulgar by tempting to realize or abstract the mental deities from their objects. Thus began priesthood. Tales.
around me to serve the God spoke to them. And whether they did not think at the time that they would be misunderstood and so be the cause of imposition. I answered, I saw no God, nor heard any infinite organical perception, but my senses discovered the infinite in everything. And as I was then persuaded and remained confirmed that the voice of honest indignation is the voice of God, I cared not for consequences but wrote.
Then I persuasion that a thing is
persuasion removes mountains, but many are not capable of a firm persuasion of anything. Then Ezekiel said, the philosophy of the East taught the first principles of human perception. Some nations held one principle for the origin and some another. We of Israel taught that the poetic genius was the first principle and all the others merely derivative, which was the cause of our despising the priests and philosophers of other countries of prophesying that all gods would at last be proved to originate in ours, to be tributaries of the poetic genius. It was this that our great poet King David desired so fervently in his hope so pathetically saved by this. He conquers enemies and governs kingdoms, and we so loved our God that we cursed in his name all the deities of surrounding nations and asserted that they had rebelled. From these opinions the vulgar came to think that all nations would at last be subject to the Jews.
Yeah. To act Zerat, he said, between the black and white spiders.
Yeah. liberty to speak of themselves as the only wise. This they do with the confident insolence sprouting from systematic reasoning.
Yeah. sinking hair, shot like the sinking sun into the western sea. Awakened from his eternal sleep, the hoary element roaring fled away. Down rushed, beating his wings.